Let's learn about bite-wing radiography. What is bite-wing radiography? It's a technique of intraoral radiography which is used to examine the interproximal surfaces of the teeth. A bite-wing image includes the crowns of maxillary and mandibular teeth, the interproximal areas, and the areas of crestal bone. Why is this technique called as bite-wing technique? It's because in the original technique, it required the patient to bite on a small wing of paper attached to the film packet. So this is the wing of paper on which patient was supposed to bite, hence the name bite wing technique. The principles of bite wing technique are: the receptor is placed in the mouth parallel to the crowns of both maxillary and mandibular teeth. So the film is placed parallel to both maxillary and mandibular teeth. And the receptor is stabilized when the patient bites on the bite wing tab or the bite block of the beam alignment device. And the central X-ray beam is directed through the contacts of the teeth at a vertical angulation of plus 10 degrees. For bite wing technique, it requires a special beam alignment device and a bite wing tab. So this is the bite wing tab on which the patient is supposed to bite, and this is the alignment device which helps to align the X-ray beam perpendicular to the X-ray film. What is the horizontal angulation in bite wing technique? So horizontal angulation refers to the positioning of the central ray in a horizontal or side to side plane. So what is the correct horizontal angulation? The central ray is directed perpendicular to the curvature of the arch and through the contact areas of the teeth. This is the curvature of the arch and a tangent, and the central ray should be perpendicular to the tangent of the curvature of the arch. As a result, the contact areas on the exposed image appear open and can be examined for evidence of caries. So this is the tangent to the curvature of the arch, and the central ray is perpendicular to the tangent. What is a vertical angulation? Vertical angulation refers to the positioning of PID or position indicating device in a vertical or up and down plane. That is the angulation in the vertical plane. The vertical angulation of plus 10 degrees recommended when a bite wing tab is used without a beam alignment device. That is, the 10 degree is used to compensate for the slight bend of the upper portion of the receptor due to the slight tilt of the maxillary teeth. As the maxillary teeth are slightly buccally tilted when compared to the mandibular teeth, to compensate for this change in the angulation between the upper and the lower teeth, is plus 10 degree vertical angulation is used. Here we can observe that film is also slightly bent when it is kept parallel to the maxillary teeth, and hence the central ray is directed plus 10 degree as vertical angulation. Now the rules for bite wing technique. The receptor placement should cover the prescribed teeth. It should be positioned parallel to the teeth, stabilized by the patient biting on a tab or an XAP bite block. Vertical angulation is plus 10 degrees. Horizontal angulation is zero, directed through the contact points. And receptor exposure, the central ray should be centered on the receptor. So guidelines for the bite wing receptor placement. If using the film, the wide side of the film always faces the teeth. When using a sensor, position of the sensor towards the X-ray tube should be according to the manufacturer instructions. If using the film, the identification dot has no significance in bite wing placement. Whereas while taking the IOPA images, the identification dot should always be towards the occlusal surface. It does not have any role in case of bite wing technique. In posterior bite wing series, receptors are placed horizontally or vertically according to the requirement. When positioning the receptor or film, always center the film over the area to be examined. When positioning the receptor, ask the patient to slowly bite on the bite wing tab or bite block of the beam alignment device, and always make certain that the bite block or tab is stabilized by the teeth and not the lips. This is how the bite wing film should cover the both maxillary and mandibular crowns. A good bite wing image shows open contact in the premolar region as thin radiolucent lines. Note that the occlusal plane is positioned horizontally along the midline of the long axis of the image. A non-diagnostic bite wing shows overlapped interproximal contacts. Here you can see overlapping of the contacts. So a good image should show open contacts. Vertical bite wings. A vertical bite wing image can be used to examine the level of the alveolar bone in addition to the caries detection. The vertical bite wing is placed with the long portion of the receptor in an up and down or vertical direction. However, the central rate remains the same, that is plus 10 vertical angulation. Why do we need to take bite wing radiography? What are the indications? The first and foremost indication is to detect the incipient interproximal dental caries. Now, dental caries is also detected in IOPA radiographs. Then why do we need to take bite wing, or how is bite wing superior to IOPA in detecting incipient caries? It's because the horizontal angle of projection here, the beam is directed almost horizontally to the teeth and the film. The central beam is essentially perpendicular. So the central beam is also perpendicular to the film, and central beam is directed through the interproximal spaces because of the horizontal angle of the projection. In IOPA, especially in the bisecting angle technique, the central beam is projected perpendicular to the imaginary bisector between the tooth and the film. Whereas here, the vertical angulation is plus 10, which is almost horizontal angle of projection. And the central beam is essentially perpendicular. According to the rules of the projection geometry, the beam should be perpendicular to the object and the receptor in order to obtain an accurate image. So here, the central beam is essentially perpendicular. Also, central beam is directed through the interproximal spaces. Hence, we can accurately detect the incipient caries. Also, the object-to-film distance is relatively small. Here you can see that as the IOPA film covers the periapical region and there is an alveolar bone, so the film is placed slightly away from the tooth. Whereas in bite wing, the film covers only the exposed crown portions and it's placed very close to the teeth. So, object to film distance is relatively small, and because of that, the image distortion caused by the projection phenomenon are minor. Because of all these features, bite wing is superior to IOPA in detecting incipient caries, also to monitor the progress of the caries, to assess the existing restorations, and to detect the caries under the restoration, to detect cemental caries, to assess the size and shape of the pulp chamber and the pulp stones, to reveal the caries in multiple teeth, especially in upper and lower teeth in a single radiograph, to examine the crestal bone levels between the teeth, to detect chronic resorption of the interalveolar bone, to detect the subgingival calculus. Since the film is kept close to the teeth, it's easy to detect subgingival calculus, and to detect and assess furcation involvement, to determine the relationship of the permanent tooth bud to the deciduous tooth. These are the indications of bite wing radiographs. What are the modifications in bite wing technique? Suppose the patient has edentulous space. How should we take the bite wing? So a cotton roll must be placed in the area of the missing tooth or teeth to support the bite wing tab. And when the patient closes, the opposing teeth occlude on the cotton roll and support the bite wing tab. And if there is a bone growth, such as tori, so then the receptor must be placed between the tori and the tongue and not on the tori, because it may change the inclination or the angulation of the film. Hence, it should be placed between the tori and the tongue and then exposed. So with this, we come to the end of bite wing technique. Thank you.